Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 9 of our GoLang course. It's time to introduce you to operators. We will cover different kind of operators available in Go and how they're used. Some of them we have already used in our examples, like the assignment operator and the colon equal shorthand used for assignment. There are a lot of different operators available to us, and this can be overwhelming at first. But don't worry, this is just a broad introduction to operators in Go. Throughout the course, we will cover each kind in depth when appropriate. First, we will cover operators and operands. Then, we will cover different kinds of operators. And lastly, but not the least, we will discuss operator precedence. So let's begin. The Go language specification has a line describing operators, which I love. It says, operators combine operands into expressions. These expressions are then evaluated to perform programming logic. Programming is indeed the evaluation of a bunch of expressions and statements. Before we start, let us first discuss operators and operands. Here we have two expressions. The first represents addition of 10 with 5, and the second one represents subtraction of 4 from 20. The plus and minus sign are the operators in this expression, and 10 and 5 and 20 and 4 are the operands. Operators are symbols that are used to perform arithmetic or logical operations. The ones we have here are performing arithmetic operation of addition and subtraction. Operations are performed on the operands, as we saw in the example above. In our expression above, 10, 5, 20, and 4 are all operands that the operators are performing the operation on. There are two kinds of operators, binary and unary. The binary operators perform operations on two operands, while the unary operator performs the operation on a single operand. So let's first get the unary operator out of our way. Generally speaking, we are all familiar with binary operators as they sit between two operands, just like our regular math. So as we saw in the previous example, A plus B plus sign is a binary operator that operates on A and B. Unary operators are different in that they only operate on a single operand. We have most of the unary operators in Go here. They are written right next to the operands as postfix or suffix. Example of postfix is x plus plus, which will increment the value of x. And example of suffix is ampersand x, which gives you the memory address of x. Let us move to arithmetic operators, which, as the name suggests, are used to perform arithmetic operations on operands. All arithmetic operators are binary operators. As we see in mathematics, the plus sign or the sum operator is used to add two operands. Like in our example here, a plus b, where a plus b can be of any numeric type or strings. In adding different numeric types with each other, it will result in the result being of the same type as the operand on the left of the operator. So if a is int and b is float, and we are adding 2, the result will be int. And if a is float and we are adding a int b, the result will be float. The same rule of type conversion applies if you are using any arithmetic operator for different numeric types. Additionally, you can only use the sum operator with strings if both of the operands are strings. The minus sign or the difference operator is used to get difference between two operators, or in other words, perform subtraction. The expression a minus b will give you difference between the two, where a or b can be of any numeric type. The asterisk, as we generally know, is the product operator and is used to perform multiplication of two operands. So a asterisk b will give you the multiplication of a multiplied by b. It too can only be used with numeric types. Forward slash here represents the division operator and is used to divide operands on the left side of the operand with the operand on the right side. So a forward slash b means a divided by b. It can be used for all numeric data types. The percent sign, as we generally know, is used to get the remainder of operands on the left when divided by operand on the right. A percent sign b will give you the remainder value when a is divided by b. It can be only used with integer data types, which are int and unsigned int. Now let us discuss bitwise, logical, and shift operators. These are used for binary operations. All the bitwise operators can be used with integer data types or the int and unsigned int data types. These operators are used for bit manipulation. An example of this is network programming, where bit manipulation is very common to work with, as you work with raw data, which is represented by bits. The first operator we have here is the ampersand symbol, or the bitwise AND. The bitwise AND performs the logical AND operation of the two operands. So A ampersand B will perform the logical AND operation for the bit representation of two integer values A and B. Here, integer values represent int and unsigned int. We will discuss this more in a lesson dedicated to just bitwise operator. Similarly, the bar symbol represents logical OR, which is used to perform logical OR operation of two operands, or the bitwise OR. A bar B, or A or B, is performing the bitwise OR operation to bit representation of the two integer values A and B. Again, integers here are int and unsigned int. The caret sign represents bitwise OR operator used to perform the OR operation on two operands. It is written as A caret sign B, and it again is only applicable for integers and unsigned ints. The next operator is used to perform bit clear, or a combination of AND and NOT operation. It is a two character operator combining ampersand AND and caret. The last two are shift operators used to shift bits in the binary representation of the integer value. The double left arrow operator is used to shift bits in the operand on the left by the number of bits on the right of the operator. So A double left arrow 1 means shifting the bit representation of A by 1 to the left. Similar is the case for a double right arrow, where double right arrow 1 means shifting the bit representation of A by 1 bit to the right. Again, all these only work with integer data types, or int and unsigned int. Next, we have the comparison operators. We haven't covered conditional checks yet, or the if checks, where these operators are useful. So for now, we're just going to look at what they mean in the context of operations. We will cover these operators in depth once we have covered conditional or the if checks. As we have seen in the examples before, a single equal sign is an assignment operator that is used to assign the value on the right to the variable on the left of the assignment or equal to operator. A double equal to sign, on the other hand, means equality check. So if I'm saying A equal B, I'm saying to check if A is equal to B in value and type. The result of this expression will be evaluated as a Boolean value. It will either be true or false, depending on if A is equal to B or not, respectively. Next, we have the negation sign in front of the equal sign. This operator represents the not equal check. The result of A not is equal to B will be true if A is not equal to B in value and type, and false if A is indeed equal to B in value and type. A single left arrow is used to perform the less than check. A left arrow B, or A less than B expression, is evaluated to be true if A is indeed less than B, or false otherwise. Next, we have the left arrow followed by the equal sign. The operator is used to perform the less than equal check. So if I say A less than equal to B, it will be true if A is indeed less than equal to B, or false otherwise. The next two operators that we have here are very similar but opposite to ones we just looked at. The right arrow operator, or the greater than operator, is used to check if A is greater than B. If A is indeed greater than B, it will be evaluated true or false otherwise. Last, we have the greater than or equal to check, which is the right arrow followed by the equal sign. The expression A greater than equal to B will be evaluated true if A is indeed greater than or equal to B, or false otherwise. Before we start talking about logical operators, I think it is a good time to take a short break. In the next part of this lesson, we will continue talking about the logical operators. See you in the next part.